In this video, we're going to take a look at percents with addition and subtraction. So percent problems where there's a discount or there's a tax or a markup. And the key in these problems is to pay close attention to what the problem is asking. Is it asking for the final price, or is it just asking for how much the price has gone up or down? So problem one says, what is the total price of a $5 book with a 10% sales tax? So tax gets added on to the price of items. So 10% of $5, we can just move the decimal point over and would be 50 cents. And since it's asking for, it's not asking for the tax, it's asking for the total price. So we gotta add that tax on to the price of the book, and we get our final answer of $5.50. Number two, a guitar marked at $5.50 is on sale for 30% off. This word off here means subtraction. It means we're going to have to find 30% and subtract it away. What is the sale price of the guitar? So 10% of $5.50 would be 550 divided by 10, or 55. So 30% is 3 of those, 3 55s, or 55 times 3. Well, 50 times 3 is 150, 5 times 3 is 15, so 150 plus 15, 165. So the most common error students make is giving this as their answer, $165. But that's not the price of the guitar. The guitar is being sold for 30% off. So we have to take 30% of the price, which is 165, and subtract it away from 550. And when we do that, we're going to get 385 dollars. One other way that you can solve discount problems is by realizing that when you take away 30%, right, what you're left with is 70% of the price, because you've taken away 30%. So you're left with 70%. So instead of finding 30% and subtracting from the price, you could just go directly to find 70%. So if 10% was 55, if I do 55 times 7, I'll get 70% of the price of the guitar. And lo and behold, that comes out to $385, which is what we got when we subtracted 30%. And that makes sense, because when you subtract 30%, you're left with 70%. Number three. Which of the following equations could be used to find the sale price, P, of the guitar? Well, this speaks to what we just did in green. Choice A would be finding 30% of the guitar, 0.30 times 550. That's not the sale price. That's how much we subtract. Choice B says divide by 10. That gets you 10%. Multiply by 3. That also gets you 30%. And choice C is just taking away $30. Which is not 30%. But choice D says multiply 550 by 0.70, which would get you 70% of the original price, and that is a way to find the sale price of the guitar. Number four. Miss Dana plans to buy $168 worth of school supplies at Lakeshore Learning. She has a coupon that gives her a 25% discount on all purchases over $100. How much does Miss Dana spend at Lakeshore? So here we have a discount. That means we need to find 25% of 168 and subtract it away. And the fastest way to find 25% is to divide by 4, because 25% is 1/4 or 1/4. So that gets us 42. So we're going to now take that and subtract it away, because discount means subtract from the original price. And we get $126. Number five, generous Gabby wants to leave a 20% tip on a meal that costs $35. How much should Gabby leave as a tip? Well, tip works much the same way as tax does. You add it on to the final cost. So let's see, a 10% tip would be $3.50. That means a 20% tip would be $7. Another way we could have gotten there is by dividing 35 by 5, since 20% is 1/5. So now we're just going to add $7 onto 35 to get the final price of the meal. However, I just did what I told you not to do at the start of this video. I answered the question, what's the final price of the meal? But what it's asking is, how much should Gabby leave as a tip? So the answer is simply $7, because that's what she should leave as a tip. Number six, the final problem we're going to look at. Well, maybe we'll look at number seven as well. Number six, Darion purchases a jar of pickles for $3.80. He marks the price up by 40% and sells the jar to Mr. Peter. How much did Darion charge Mr. Peter for the jar of pickles? Well, he marks the price up. Marking the price up means he's adding on to the price. So he's adding 40% on to the price of $3.80. Well, again, let's find 10% first. 10% of $3.80 is 38 cents. We move the decimal over once. So 40% would be 0.38 times 4, which is 120 plus 32, $1.52. So if Darion's marking the price up by $1.52 and he bought it for $3.80, he's going to charge me $5.32 for the jar of pickles. Number seven. California's state tax rate of 7.25% is the highest in the nation. Colorado's rate of 2.9% is one of the lowest. Mr. Peter is planning to purchase a Range Rover, false, which has a base cost of $89,000. He is considering driving to Colorado to make the purchase in order to save money. How much money would Mr. Peter save by purchasing the Range Rover in Colorado instead of in California? So the reason I ended up wanting to look at this is to show you a shortcut. We could find 7.25% of 89,000 and then find 2.9% of 89,000 and find the difference, right? Subtract away, and that would be how much I'd save. But instead, let's do the subtraction up front. Let's start the problem off with subtraction, and then we'll only have to multiply one time. So let's subtract 2.9 from 7.25 to find the difference in percent in tax rates. Let's see, 72 minus 30 is 42, so 43. So 4.35% is how much lower Colorado's tax rate is than California's. So if we just multiply 89,000 by 4.35%, we're going to find how much I save. And a fast way to do that is let's find 1% of 89,000, which we can take off two zeros, right, is $890. And then we're going to multiply by the percent we're looking for, 4.35. And I'm going to use a calculator to do this real quick. We would get $3,871.50. So doing the subtraction at the start of our problem allowed us to only have to multiply one time instead of twice. twice and then subtract at the end.